it's Jeffrey with Real Nifty Vintage, and today I'm back with another haul video. So the items here I'm gonna show you are from a couple separate times I went out thrifting. One of them I went to Savers and Goodwill, and then the other part of this haul is from an antique mall. So I've got quite a selection, but I'm gonna first start off with something that had a little bit of an accident, and it was my fault. I was a little too aggressive in cleaning this. I have a toothbrush that I use to get in the tight areas, and I was getting in right here in these areas, and I was like going like this, as if I was like sawing a piece of wood, and I accidentally broke off this. So you can't really tell, because I glued it back together, and then I did a great job. But the sale, let's get closer. Can you see, or where is it? Okay, it's right here, Okay, and then down here, you can see the bottom one better, kind of goes along there. Okay, so that's broken off. It's really unfortunate. I paid $3 at Goodwill for this, and because of the break, I'm probably gonna just stick it in the booth, which is fine because I have a booth near in Carlisle, Illinois. Has Illinois' largest man-made lake, and so this kind of stuff does pretty well in the booth. So I'm gonna go ahead and put it in the booth. It's from 1979, and because it's now broken, I'm gonna put about $10 on it and just take that loss as it is. But I was so upset whenever it broke, I was like, argh. So that's that one. The same day, I actually went over to Savers, and I found this one right here. It's a penguin, also Otagiri, and it plays You Light Up My Life. Very, very nice. The other one, by the way, it plays Ebb Tide. So that's the song on the sailboats. But this is porcelain, really, really nice. No chips or cracks on this one. And I paid $4 for this wind-up musical figurine, Japan. This one I'll put online for probably $26 to $28 with shipping included. And then at Savers, I bought this big old glass paperweight. It's large, and I think it's hollow, actually. It has a lot of weight to it, but I believe it's hollow. It has this lattice on here, these swirls, very similar to like an old German marble. Very nice, and it does have a shiny bottom, which whenever you have glass like this and the pontil mark has been ground down, it's suspected that it has better quality because someone took the extra initiative to polish down that rough mark where it would have been attached to the pole whenever they were blowing this. So I paid $5 for it, and it has the original price tag on it. I think it's the original. $15. So I'm gonna put that online for right around $30 with shipping included on Etsy. Very nice large paperweight. We're gonna switch gears a little bit. I went to an antique mall and I found this amazing deal. I think I paid like $3 or something for this parrot. It's a wall pocket in majolica. Majolica is just the glaze type, being made of lead or tin, but I love the colors on here. It's a made in Japan item, I'm sure. Oh yeah, here it is. Oh, it's a made in occupied Japan item, so 1945 to 1952 time frame. Very pretty. I just love the colors, no chips or cracks, and I could not believe the price of this wall pocket. It's a vase. It's a wall pocket vase. Beautiful. You know what? I said that it's a wall pocket, but I'm not actually sure how you hang this. Maybe you just have to hang it like a hook because it's not flat on any side. So I guess it wouldn't go on your wall necessarily. So yeah, you could just hang it from the ceiling kind of. That's really cool. I like this a lot. It's probably going to go up for around $28 to $30 with shipping included. Very cool. Oh, I had to buy a little kitten at Goodwill because the price was right. 50 cents for this one here. Little tabby cat. Beautiful. Look at that. 50 cents. Porcelain. Very nice. I'm gonna put that up for probably about $20, 18 to 20 with shipping included on that one. I also bought this wonderful Inesco planter of the tree trunk with the skunk. Very, very cute. It's marked on the bottom right here. It says Inesco, and I paid $3 for it. That's Inesco 1979. Now, in the moment, I did realize that there was a hairline, actually two hairlines that are not, they're not structural, which is great. So you can see them from the inside. They don't go all the way through, so it's not gonna fall apart, which is great. But this is just a wonderful, I love picking up skunk items. I don't see them as often as other animal items, so I took a chance on this one here. It'll probably go up for about $24 with shipping included. At the antique mall, I found, actually Barb found these amazing chalkware elephants. Would have been probably hung in a nursery, but I'm looking for, I just realized I never did look for a mark on these. They're oftentimes made by Miller Studios. I don't see any mark on these, so I don't know, but they're chalkware, plaster. We've got this elephant right here. Look at that, airbrushed, very, very nice. And then we've got this one right here. It's the larger one. So the pair of them were about $10. What a great price. And then they were doing, or it was $9, I think, with 20% off in the booth. What a great, great deal. So they're practically new looking. I mean, there's hardly any issues at all on them. Tiny micro abrasions, nothing really that bad. So I'm gonna put these up for probably close to $30 with shipping included. People were commenting Dumbo. Yeah, they kind of remind me of Dumbo. And elephant trunks are up. That's always a good sign. Good luck. And then we have this, like, the circus kind of idea here. So it's really cool. I think those were a great find by Barb. I also, in the same booth, she found this here. It was hiding behind a cabinet. This is black amethyst. Or I imagine it's purple glass, but it's black depression glass for sure. And it has wonderful painted, look at that. Very thickly applied paint, also known as impasto, whenever it's globbed on like that and very textural. And it's just really nice. So it's this black 1920s kind of glass ice bucket with this wonderful handle. Look at the little diamond texture on here. I don't know if that'll focus or not. Yeah, there's like this texture right on the handle. Very cool, like little diamonds. Very pretty. So that is an awesome ice bucket that'll hang on to it for a little bit, and then I may decide to sell eventually. Very, very cool. I also picked up this pineapple napkin holder. And it was only $1.49 at Savers. I never see things at Savers that cheap, but it was $1.50 for this monkey pod wood pineapple napkin holder. I'll put this up for about $20 with shipping included, and I don't think I'll have a problem with that. It's a very nice, practical item. The last item that I got from Savers is actually this. Oh, it's marked Japan on the back. See, I didn't even look. It was $4, and it's this wonderful metal eagle. These are very cool. It reminds me of like the 70s, whenever this kind of early American stuff was really coming back because of like the bicentennial. Was it the bicentennial? Yeah. So very nice. It's kind of hollow, but where'd that thing go? There it is. Yeah, it says Japan right on the back. It's embossed. So paid $4. I'll probably put this up for maybe a little bit over $30 with shipping included, but yeah, that's really great. You can hang that on the wall, put it out on your house. I see houses with these things like hanging on their, like over their garage doors too. But all in all, that was the haul. Not a whole lot of stuff, but still some pretty interesting things, and those will be going up on Etsy very soon. So with that, I'm gonna wrap up this video. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Bye-bye.